Ready? It's sing-along time.
My name is Duann, and I am so excited to see you. This month, we're talking about the King of Kings. And do you remember who the King of all kings is? Let's hear it on the count of three. One, two, three. Yes, it's Jesus! And that is our big idea this month. Jesus is the King of Kings. Okay, so I have something fun for us to do. You see my bag there? Let's go over to the table and see what's inside. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take out all the items out of the bag, and you have to help me figure out which item doesn't belong. You think you can help me? Okay, let's do this. All right, there's an angel. Okay, what else? Oh, there's a lamb. Bah. Okay, a lamb. There's a banana. Okay, and what else? Oh, it's a figurine of baby Jesus. Okay. We have one more thing in our bag. A star. Okay, so what doesn't belong? Well, let's see. This reminds me of something. When baby Jesus was born, there was an angel that told the shepherds, right? The shepherds that Jesus was born. And the shepherds were watching sheep. And there was a star. There was a star that showed where Jesus was born. Okay, and then the banana. Did you guess it? The banana isn't in the story. That was so much fun. Okay, so these items remind me of the story of when Jesus was born, and we call that Christmas. That was fun. So today in Storytime, we're gonna talk about a story that happened before Jesus was born. Let's go to Storytime.
Storytime!
Hi friends, I'm Willem. Today, I've got an awesome story for you that's got angels, adventure, and a donkey. All right, let's check it out. Joseph and Mary were engaged to be married. And that's normally a very exciting time in anybody's life. Woo! But one night, after Joseph fell asleep, he had a dream that was even more exciting. Oh, I love when I have a good and exciting dream. But let's get back to the story. In this dream, an angel of the Lord told Joseph that Mary will become pregnant and have a very special baby. And this baby is God's son. The angel told Joseph that he has to take good care of Mary and the baby, and that he will call the baby Jesus. Joseph loved Mary very much, and he also loved God very much, so he wanted to do exactly what the angel told him. Joseph got married to Mary, and soon after that, they heard that the emperor, that's kind of like the ruler or the king, he wanted everyone to go to their hometowns to be counted, because he wanted to see how many people lived in the country. Joseph and Mary took a very long trip to go to Joseph's hometown, Bethlehem. They had to walk very, very far. In those days, they would take a donkey and they would pack their stuff on the donkey. But with Mary being pregnant, she would also ride on the donkey. I don't think it'd be very comfortable to ride on a donkey, but I bet you it was a lot better than walking all that distance. When Joseph and Mary got to Bethlehem, they couldn't find a place to stay. Aww. Every room in town was booked. The hotels and inns were all full. Joseph finally found an inn manager who said they could stay in the place where they kept their animals. And you know what? That would be where Jesus was born. Let's wrap it up here, and you guys can head on over to activity time.
Activity time!
Hi, friends! It's so nice to see you. All right, Evan, I have a question for you.
What's your question?
What would you do if an angel brought you a message?
I'd probably try to do exactly what the angel told me to do.
Awesome, because you know, angels are messengers. So, let's play a game where we bring messages all around us.
That seems fun.
It might be a little bit silly, but the message is gonna be, Jesus is going to be born. Can you say that with me?
Jesus is gonna be born.
Great. Now, let's go and tell a pet or a stuffed animal that Jesus is going to be born.
Jesus is gonna be born.
Jesus is going to be born. Awesome.
Okay, now let's go tell a wall, Jesus is gonna be born.
Evan, that is so silly, but let's do it anyway.
Jesus is going to be born!
Awesome, now let's go tell a family member or a friend that Jesus is going to be born.
Did you do it? Great. Okay, and one last one. Let's say to each other as loud as we can, Jesus is going to be born. Jesus is going to be born!
Awesome. Thank you so much for playing with us, friends. You know what that was? That was like the message that the angel gave to Joseph.
And we know Jesus was born, grew up, and showed all the world God's great big love for us.
Wow. I hope you enjoyed that game. I had so much fun for sure.
I did too.
Now, let's get ready for Keyvers time.
Bye, friends.
Keyvers. Are you ready to learn the Keyvers? The Keyvers this month is, Jesus is the greatest king of all. Revelation 17, verse 14. Okay, I'm so excited to do the key verse with you today because we're gonna learn American Sign Language together. All right, do you remember the sign for Jesus? Put your hands up, point your middle fingers. Okay, you're gonna touch your palm with your middle fingers. Remember? Jesus. Jesus. Great. Okay, Jesus is. He is. Point your finger in the air. Touch your other finger with your thumb. The other one you do a thumbs up. He is. Hit it twice. Jesus is. Great. Okay, let's try both of those together. Jesus is. Great. Okay, what was the rest of the verse? King. Jesus is king, right? How do we do the sign for king? Put up your bunny ears. But look, on the other side, I put my thumb on my finger, so it kind of looks like a K. K for king. Okay, now we're gonna bring that to our shoulder and down to our hip. King. King. Got it? Okay, but Jesus isn't just the only king, he's the greatest king above all. How would we show that? Two thumbs up. Above all. Above all. Okay, let's put that together. So, king, the greatest king of all. You got it? You wanna try it again? The greatest king of all. Okay, let's put it all together. You ready? We'll go really slow. Jesus is the greatest king of all. Revelation 17, verse 14. Did you get it? Let's try it again. Jesus is the greatest king of all. Revelation 17, verse 14. Okay, let's try it one more time, okay? You ready? Jesus is the greatest king of all. Revelation 17, verse 14. That was great, friends. Let's see if you can teach that to someone today.
Prayer time.
It's almost time to say goodbye. But before we do, may I pray with you? How about today we get teeny tiny, like a tiny baby, like baby Jesus was. Are you tiny? Okay, let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you so much for sending your son Jesus to be born. We know that he is our king, the greatest king of all. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. I had so much fun with you today, and I look forward to seeing you again soon. Bye-bye.